Do you need to create a separate page for all your blog posts on your site? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll walk you through how to create a separate page for blog posts in WordPress. By default, when you first install WordPress, all of your blog posts are automatically added to your home page. But a lot of people want to create a home page that is a welcoming page, something static, meaning something that every visitor that comes to their site will see. And they want to move all of their blog posts to something like blog. So when you click on blog, it has all your blog posts. So I'll walk you through how to do that. The first thing you want to do is let's head over to our WordPress dashboard. The first thing we want to do is we want to create a couple of pages. So we'll go to pages, add new, and this first one we'll call home. And there's a couple of things we want to do. We'll want to turn off comments from this page. And if you don't see comments down here, then we need to go up to our screen options, click on that. And we want to click discussion, and that's good. Now we can go down here, and we just wanted to make sure that both of these are unchecked so that nobody can add a comment. Now we can publish that page, and now we want to create another one. So I'll go up here and click add new. This is the one that we'll use for all of our blog posts. So I'm going to name it blog. And you also want to make sure that the allow comments are unchecked for this as well. So for that, we can click publish. Now that we've created these two pages, we need to tell WordPress how to set this up. So let's go to our settings area under reading, and you'll see this home page displays. And by default, you see the latest posts on the home page. What we want to do is we want to set up a static home page, and the home page will be the one that you select. We'll choose the home that we created, and you'll want to add some content on there that everybody sees. And then for the posts, we want to click on the blog page that we just set up. And here's another great tip is you can show how many posts you want to show per page before they have to scroll down and click next page. 10 posts is pretty good. Some people like 5 to make it not as long. So you want to play with that for yours. And for each article in the feed, you want to show a summary or full text. Full text makes that page really long. So most people do a summary. That way people can click on the title if they want to read more. And for search engine visibility, you want to make sure that this is not selected. You want search engines to find your website. So make sure that that's unchecked. Once you're done with that, let's click Save Changes. And now if I click on my site and click Visit Site, and when I scroll down, this is my home page. Again, you'll want to add information on there to make it inviting to the user. And then if I go to my blog page, then you see all of my posts here. And from here, I can click on each one and it'll open it up to that post. Now you may have noticed that I had to type that in up here because I don't see it in my menu. That's okay. I'll show you really quickly how you can get the blog page up here as well as the home page. Let's go to my site, dashboard, and go to appearance, menus, and we want to add those two pages. They're right here for my website. The main menu is the top menu, and this is the current structure. Yours may look a little different, but I can select my blog and my home, go down here to add to menu, and by default, it'll bring it down at the bottom. So you can left click and drag these up and move them where you want. So I'm going to move that there, and I don't want this one, so I'm actually going to remove that, and I'm happy with how that looks. So once you save the menu, you can go visit our site, scroll down, and now we see our home and we see our blog. Real easy. So that's a real quick and easy way to separate your blog posts on their own page. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.